In this video, we're going to show you the cluster of Laslett for SI joint pain provocation. Hi and welcome back to Physiotutors. The cluster of Laslett is a tool used in the assessment of low back pain. One of your assessment hypotheses might be that the pain is originating from the SI joint. Originally, Laslett describes 6 provocative tests, but eventually proposes a diagnostic algorithm comprising 4 provocative tests, as the other 2 tests did not provide any additional diagnostic value. The sensitivity is reported at 88% and the specificity is reported at 78%. You can increase the specificity if your patient's symptoms do not centralize as described by McKenzie. The first test is the distraction test. The patient lies supine with the legs extended. You are going to stand on the symptomatic side and place your hands on the patient's anterior superior iliac spines. Then apply 3 to 6 moderate velocity thrusts and gradually increase pressure in a dorsolateral direction. The second test in the cluster is the thigh thrust test. Your patient is going to lie in supine position and you're going to stand on the asymptomatic side. Flex the patient's leg to 90 degrees of hip flexion and place one hand over the patient's sacrum. Then apply longitudinal pressure through the patient's femur, creating a shear force in the SI joint. Apply 3 to 6 higher velocity thrusts with gradually increasing pressure. The third test is the compression test. Ask your patient to lie on the asymptomatic side with the hips flexed to 45 degrees and knees bent to 90 degrees. You are going to position yourself behind the patient and place both of your hands on the anterior rim of the ilium. Then apply 3 to 6 vertical thrusts with moderate velocity and gradually increasing pressure. The fourth and last test in the cluster is the sacral thrust test. For the sacral thrust test, your patient is going to lie in prone position. You're going to stand next to the bench and place the palm of your hand over spinal level S2. The direction of pressure is going to be vertically downwards. Apply 3 to 6 higher velocity thrusts and gradually increase pressure. For all tests, you are looking for the provocation of your patient's familiar pain. Be aware that the described thrusts are not manual therapy thrusts. As these techniques are pain provocation techniques, be careful and start gentle first. Sometimes applying one pressure can be enough. Mark Laslett, the author of the cluster, proposes a diagnostic algorithm to evaluate the outcome of each individual test. Overall, the rule of thumb is that 2 out of 4 positive tests are needed to diagnose a symptomatic SI joint. If the first 2 tests are positive, the SI joint is likely the source of pain and no further testing is needed. If you fail to provoke pain during the first 2 tests, continue with the 3rd test. If this test is positive and you now have 2 positive tests, the SI joint is likely the source of pain. In case that the 3rd test is negative as well, continue with the sacral thrust test. If 2 tests are positive now, the diagnosis is likely a symptomatic SI joint. Are less than 2 or even all tests negative, then SI joint pain can be ruled out or is at least unlikely. Now, another cluster for SI joint provocation is the cluster of Van der Werf. You can check it out right here. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up and subscribe to our channel. Visit us on social media, links are down below. I'll see you in another video. Thanks for watching. Bye.